Hi, in this video, I answer your questions.
What type of paint, resin, and other products did you use? Where did you get all the measurements for the geometry and the exact position of some parts? Could you share your drawings with us? What's the cost of your project? How many layers and what type of carbon fiber did you use?
If you are interested by these information, keep watching!
When I decided to start this project, the idea was to make a carbon frame to replace the aluminium frame of my hybrid Norco VFR, which I used to go to work every day since the last 3 years.
So I took off the fork and I began to measure the headset outside and inside diameters.
I took a lot of other measurements, such as the bottom bracket lip and its diameter, the gaps between the dropouts and the rear wheel, axle slit, front derailleur position, and so on. Copying an existing frame allowed me to know the exact position of some critical parts, like the disc brake brackets. I also used Norco's drawings on internet to put on paper my project, and to get some of the informations which were difficult to get directly on my aluminium frame.
After 1 year working on my project, I decided to do not replace my aluminium frame. I choose to build a complete new bike.
And this project looked like a perfect and very nice challenge for me. I get to my local bike store, Bicycle Huard at Belleuil, to see real carbon bikes and be sure to get the right measurements. Thanks to Bicycle Huard to let me pass these few hours in the store manipulating their show bikes. Here are drawings I've made. This is what I used to shape and assemble all of my parts. I tried to figure out all the precise measurements on this sheet of paper. This served me as a reference throughout the entire project. As you can see, the plans are very dirty, but I'm sure you get the idea. A side view of the frame was enough to figure out the majority of the parts. Then, a small vertical view of the dropouts and the rear axle were needed to make sure to get the correct space for the rear wheel. You may know that for technical and especially security reasons, I decided to do not make my own fork. I bought a new one, which I modified.
The main product I used is this epoxy resin. This product has a resin hardener 5-to-1 ratio. It begins to be like a gel in less than 30 minutes, so you got almost 20 minutes of working time. Of course, this is at 20 Celsius degrees. I used this, this product as a filler. This is an epoxy paste. It is very thick. I use it to glue all the parts of my frame, but also as a filler sometimes. So for finishing, I use this 3M Marine Premium filler. I'm really used with it, and I had a chance to use it several times. It dries very quickly and it's very, very easy to sand. So I really like it. For the primer, I use this Interlux epoxy prime coat. This is the stuff I use on my sailboat, and this is a building material, so it fills very well the little cracks, little holes you can get on the surface, and it dries in 16 hours. I used automotive products for paint. This is a base coat, flat black, and I don't have any clear with me. The first coat of paint was applied with a HVLP spray gun, but the final coats were applied with my airbrush.
I finally applied an automotive 2-components flat clear coat to protect the paint.
it's very not easy to know precisely how much did my project cost, because I already had a lot of material and products required to build it. However, I will try to figure out a total for you.
All Shimano 105 components, the headset, the actual seat, the wheels, the fork, come from a bike which was rejected by the company on the production line and was found by my local bike store.
This is 3K 170 grams carbon fiber, and I use roughly 5 meters of this carbon fiber. I also use a thin 50 gram fiberglass to help my carbon fiber to stay in place in some tricky areas. And of course, I got other material required for the vacuum bagging technique. So here is a mix of carbon fiber and Kevlar fibers. I used it in the area of the bottom bracket tube. The number of carbon layers is different from one part to another. If you take a look at the top tube or the down tube, there are 6 layers in the center, but over 10 at the edge. I also integrated a little bit of Kevlar fibers around the bottom bracket tube. There are over 20 layers of carbon fiber. The head tube is made of more than 30 layers. The shrouds and the chainstays are made of 6 layers in the center, a little bit more at the end. I didn't count for the seat tube. Finally, the dropouts are made of full solid 6 millimeters thick carbon. I apologize for my basic English. I hope I will inspire some of you to dive into this type of project. Thanks for watching.